Is that what usually happens? Someone's like, that's it, we're done, right?
Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
I was like, I love that.
I'm that guy.
You're like, I'm over this, let's start something else. Hi, you guys.
Hi.
Introduce yourself.
Hi, we're the Fresh Kids of Bel Air.
So if you couldn't pick up on it, these guys have mastered the decade that was the 1990s. Nobody does it better than them. We're going to run through a gamut of different songs. Nobody wants to hear me speak, but can you just, who are you guys? Can you introduce yourselves?
I'm Gabrielle.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Oscar.
Hi, I love your look. Nice to meet you.
I'm Charlie Z.
Charlie Z.
I'm Robin Andre.
Robin. Yes.
I'm Matt.
I love all of you guys. I love the looks, I love the sound.
Thank you.
So tell me, how did this come about? Are you all fans of the 90s, or did you just sort of make a band and that was the...
Well, I mean, we are definitely fans of the 90s, that's why we're all here, but actually, this was an amazing idea, and it came to fruition through Marcus Linio, who is...
Marcus!
There he
Marcus,
is!
Marcus, everybody!
It came through, it was his idea, he had it going for a while, we came in, and... We actually took over and we put a whole new crew together and we brought Robin on, we later brought Gabby, we brought Matt in, Oscar, Tommy
Kessler.
You brought
Kessler. Everyone in but yourself?
We all brought everyone in and everything, but we're missing two other people in the band, unfortunately, but we want to shout out to Tommy Kessler, who's our lead guitar player, and Essay Maria, who's one of our lead female vocal singers and everything.
Where do you guys usually play? Where can people find you? And then we'll mention it.
Every Friday. Fashion Rouge.
Oh.
Am I even saying that right?
They play the same.
Are you guys after the 80s, Jesse's Girl, or before 80s Girl?
Well, we're on every Friday. They're on every Saturday.
Gotcha.
So it's in the same company. I'm all percent.
You don't need your girls
music. Yeah, yeah. But every Friday we go on right around midnight. You know, but 11 o'clock is doors, so definitely everyone come out to see us. We also play Capitol Theater, Paramount. End of the month, the 28th, we're playing the Paramount, which is going to be awesome. Playing City Winery.
You know, oh, I love City Winery.
Amazing. Yeah. You know, that's actually love coming it. Up on the 29th.
Yeah, with Michael,
Saturday.
Right? What's Michael's name?
Yeah.
Michael,
You
know what I'm talking about,
yes,
right?
Yes, I do.
Yeah, yeah. So, yeah, please, everyone come out to see us.
Definitely. Yeah. How do you pick your songs? I mean, there's a bevy of songs to choose from.
It's hard. There's
I would imagine.
400 amazing
boat?
Big pop and rock hits and everything. Yeah. We go through a whole vetting process with management. We also make sure we try songs with the crowd and make sure they respond to them. Some tunes that were gigantic in the 90s don't actually respond. And some tunes that you wouldn't think necessarily would respond as well.
They do.
They just love it. You know?
Okay.
So you just never know. We really go off the crowd.
Awesome. All right, well, give us another song, and then we'll talk again. What do you guys have?
Did you guys get that last song on tape at all? Or
it's live. We're live.
We're live.
It's all live. You guys jumped in, and we're live. If you want to keep going, like...
Awesome. Santeria.
Oh, good song, because I don't practice Santeria, so that's good.
Thank you.
across the water from Manhattan in a place called Brooklyn, 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 Brooklyn. Upper, upper, serving them hypocrites, I see. Mingling the good people we meet, yeah. Good friends we've had, good friends we've lost along the way, hey. In this great future, you can't forget your past.
Yeah, I think Spice Girls was a big thing in the 90s.
Stop it, that's the request
yeah,
you guys
yeah.
Spice Girls is a big one.
Okay. And when you say, well, I'm not going to play that, I'll play something else, what's the second? No, I'm just kidding.
We always
well,
have to play Spice Girls. But,
yeah, yeah.
I mean, God, what other teams? I mean, you must get a lot of that, right?
Yeah. I get a lot of Backstreet Boys, definitely a lot of that.
It's hard to get away from that,
but it works. We get a lot of, like, Blink 182, a lot of Green Day we get. So.
Oh, Blink 182, yeah. But that was the one I was telling you about.
Oh, wait, not Sum 41?
Not Sum 41.
I guess
Blink
182.
Yeah, they're
yeah.
just 2000s. Yeah.
I think
yeah.
they're out of our jurisdiction.
All right, that's okay.
Yeah.
Blink 182 is kind of on the cusp yeah. between that and 2000s. And Green Day was a little bit more 90s, but they're all about.
And where does Marley come in?
Oh, Marley, I'm glad you asked that question.
Okay.
Because, you know, Bob Marley, first of all, he's timeless.
Yes,
you know,
I do.
You're in a 90s band, but he's actually timeless.
He is.
And this,
so he gets a pass?
He gets a pass. And then, two, you know, we're also doing a reggae radio at the hall this Sunday. So, so we have this band called Reggae Radio, brought to you by ML Presents, and we're doing it at the Hall this Sunday, so
nice.
I'm like getting in the spirit and in the mode.
If you want to really be in the spirit, I was born in Kingston, Jamaica.
Really?
Bob Marley lived right across the street from us.
Wow.
On Pope Road, literally directly when you walk out of our apartment building.
Wow.
He was
when
right
he was
across
Bob
the street.
Marley
nope,
he
was a crazy guy who smoked a ton of pot and who had crazy music playing, and the security would always call police because the crazy guy was playing music again. And that crazy guy turned into Bob Marley.
That's awesome.
So I really fully appreciate when you brought that in. What's that?
I just assumed you were great. I just assumed you guys knew that.
Also, I'd love to hear something else. What else do you guys want to play?
I don't know. You want to try Torn?
Sure.
Let's do that. We're going to pick you, Gabby, on this one. 1, 2, 3, 4.
He showed me what it was right. You couldn't feed that man, I adored. Don't seem to know, you seem to care what your heart is for. I don't need him anymore. He's nothing where he was a lie. But conversation has been dry. That's what's going on. Nothing's fine, I'm torn. I'm all afraid. This is how I feel. Cold and I am shaking. The light is making on the floor. You should never change. It's a
listening to. What's your favorite 90s artist?
Well, it's kind of like when I was 7 years old, I always dreamed of being a Spice Girl. So I really did. I actually found a video of me dressed up like a Spice Girl dancing around in my living room.
Beautiful.
Very embarrassing.
That's,
but I made all my...
Yeah. So on Thursday, right?
So on Thursday, this happened, and you know. So yeah, probably the Spice Girls for me.
Okay.
Yeah.
Nirvana. By far. Okay.
Really?
Yeah. Without a doubt.
It's a little heavy for me. I was worried that you were going to come in and only play like... super intense, like grungy Nirvana music. You're so hippie and pop. A lot of pop. It's good. What about you?
Yeah.
I love a lot of the. I love 90s hip hop.
Talk to me.
I mean, I know it's kind of.
Yeah, it's
obvious,
good.
I mean,
yeah.
But I also like the. You know, I like the alternative stuff because it gets me to branch out a little.
Right.
My comfort zone, you know, like be a little more diverse.
Who is your favorite hip hop band?
No, I love the Redman. You know, I like the Tupacs, I like the Biggies.
Yeah. Gotcha.
Awesome.
Yeah. That live one. Yeah, like I did. Fugees, I did.
Yeah, Fugees.
Yeah.
You have a story about the Fugees, don't you?
Do you know the Fugees?
No. Every time I make a run, girl, you turn around and cry. That story, man. You don't want to hear.
Yes.
That. What's that?
Seem like a good story. What's your favorite band?
Oddly enough, I'm pretty thin slick between Green Day and Dave Matthews.
Oh, Dave Matthews! I forgot about Dave Matthews. That's right. Those were the songs that started off, and they were like a great 2 minute song, and then you played for another 18 minutes after that, right? And you were like, "Well, I guess now's when I go to the bathroom at a concert, and then like make."
Peach. Yeah. Make peach.
Right? Or something that takes a long time. Alright, let's do something else, if you don't mind.
Sure. Let's see. How about we do... Want to try 500 miles? What do you think, Gossip?
Sure.
Want to try that harmony? Cool. Here we go.
Brings me back to ninth grade in case anyone is wondering.
Oh!
Gossip Proclaimers.
Oh,
request that, and now I want to hear nothing but that.
I didn't know that song until we started doing it.
Oh, because you're 12.
Yeah. These guys are a lot older than I am.
No, you weren't even alive in the 90s. Like, what are you talking about?
I was going to say, I remember it from my 50th birthday.
I know. Meanwhile, he was born in, like, 2004. That's great. That's an awesome song. When was Peter Gabriel in the 90s, too?
80s.
In the 80s?
I'm obsessed with him.
I loved it. I don't even know what to say.
Do you guys do shiny, happy people?
We haven't gotten really heavy.
I don't know. Somebody just was asking.
No one wants them to be every single song. It's not like a happy
song. We tried Metallica one or two times. And
we haven't hit. We haven't hit.
What is the absolute biggest crowd pleaser?
All the Small Things.
Yeah. Really?
Has been one of the consistently All-Star.
I don't even know how it goes.
All the Small Things. It's a great song to work out to.
That's a good one.
It's true.
Third Eye Blind, Semi-Charmed.
No. That was stuck in my head for 3 months and 4 days. I never got that out. I did a whole piece with them.
Well, we're going to do it.
No. We're not doing that song.
Please do it. I'm the producer of the show.
So give her the key.
I got it.
You got it?
Yeah.
Yeah. One, two, three.
You will tell me what I want, but I'll leave you really want. So tell me what you want, what you really, really want.
Dreams coming true.
Like the 80s band, do you guys get all dressed up or?
Yeah.
Yes. Is it? Okay. Yeah. I don't even remember. If I got dressed up in what I wore in the 90s, it would just be
that's probably disaster. One of the most exciting parts, because we get to dress up like the artist. So there's like an element of acting to it, too. So
yeah.
You go on the stage and you act and you are this character.
Right.
And like the crowd goes wild for you, so you can only imagine what it would be like to be like a Spice Girl or Blink-182 or Blink-182. It's pretty cool.
That's awesome. All right, well, you mentioned Blink-182. You look like you love Blink-182.
Yeah, I do, actually.
You look like Blink-182. You are basically.
I'm a drummer. I'm a track sparker. So it all works, you know what I mean?
Awesome. Oh, yeah, that's who's married to Pink, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Really?
Was, right? God, you're so young. You're so cute. No, you're adorable. These are all compliments.
He just turned 13. Poor Matt.
He was born in the 90s, so.
You were born in the 90s? That's pathetic.
Just there.
Four of my kids were born in the 90s.
What's that?
Four of my kids were born in the 90s.
Really?
Children.
Really?
90s.
Alright, let's do it.
Let's do it up.
So do you guys want to do want to do all the small things? Can we do that?
Yeah.
Let's do that first. Since we're doing so many twos. Great,
there we go. Can we do like, can you do like two more?
No, we'll do a ton more. We can do tons. Yeah, let's do all the small things.
You don't have to. Yeah. You guys
no,
do
no,
whatever
it's
you
a great team.
Okay.
So. Yeah, right, comes on. A one, two.
Show, there's 11 people on stage.
It's crazy.
That's awesome. And How do you decide who's going to sing what song?
Well, we just try to divvy it up. You know, I'm the music director, so I actually go through and say, okay, Oscar has this many tunes, and Matt has this many tunes. Yeah, so I try to keep everyone even. And there's five lead singers in the band, which it gets really hard, and there's only so many tunes you can do. So each week we'll switch things up and change order and everything. Yeah,
nice.
So.
All right, it's actually from the Peanut Gallery.
Yeah.
What they do is they're changing costumes a lot of times, so some of the singers will go off and change into another costume.
Oh, okay. Gotcha.
While the other singer is singing.
But the show never stops. It's like one giant 90s song. Boom, boom, boom. It's really, it's fun.
It's a nostalgia overload.
Yeah, it's a nostalgia overload. It never stops.
No, the only bad thing is that I can't stay up till midnight. Otherwise,
we have early shows. We're playing the Paramount. We are playing Blue Night a lot. With the 2000s band opening on Friday.
What are they called?
Friday. They're called TRL.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah.
That's a good name. I love the name. You guys, your names are great.
Yeah. That's all that matters. Nice. But we go on, I believe, at 9 o'clock in the 90s at the Paramount Theater in Huntington, Long Island.
Okay.
So that's this coming Friday, the 28th.
Nice.
So tickets are still available.
A week from today.
A week from today. Exactly.
All right, give us two more songs, whatever you got. What do you want?
You want. Let's, why don't we do Semi-Charmed and then What's My Age Again? Let's do that, shall we?
Cool.
Here we go.
Awesome. Let's just help each other.
Yeah.
G, C, and D, and it changes.
G, C, and D?
Yeah.
Yeah. Play the chord.
G, D, and C.
One, two, three.
What you wanna do, coming over you. Smile and blow me go through. One stop to the rhythm that divides you. And I speak to you like the course of the verse. Chop another line like a fiddle with a curse. Coming like a freak show, takes the stage. Give up in the place she said.
I want something else. Get me through this. Such a kind of life.
Me through this life, baby, I want something else.
probably be completely inappropriate, but this is what I do. So I feel like this is the kind of guy I dated back in the 90s. Like, you look just like the kind of guy I would have gone on a date with in the 90s.
What kind of guy is that?
No, just like...
the one who made her into a lesbian.
No, you're adorable, and are you... I think that's why I was like, wow, it really feels like I'm back in the 90s again.
Oh,
anyway,
well, maybe we can set you up. Yeah, you guys are recruiting for my team now.
Okay, what are you going to end with? Something great.
Well, I was more
Blink-182.
You know,
why not?
So,
I'm going to have to get a Blink-182 album. I never heard of these.
So good.
What? I never knew what they were. I, like,
they're really nice.
I didn't really, like, I didn't.
You should check out the videos, too. There's an amazing couple of videos that they did parodying all this stuff in the 90s.
Are they on vinyl or are they on cassette?
They're on
CD. Oh, they're
on CD. They're actually on
H-Track,
too.
H-Track.
You really don't know.
I need to even like this.
I don't know.
But yeah,
this is
a good video. So, shall?
Yeah.
One, two, three.
Personalities, so keep on doing all of it, and come back and play with us anytime, please. We would love it.
Definitely.
Nice. We're usually on the rooftop of my building. It's really awesome. It's great, but of course, bad weather. So we'll come back again and do it the right way.
Alright,
cool.
Yeah, thank you so
much
for having us.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah,
I want to get a
picture. Yeah, I get the picture. Let's go. Take. Why don't you jump on?
Jump in here.
I'll be there within an hour.
Almost.
Smile. One that people can see.
Alright. Good deal.
Thanks, Billy.
Thank you.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks for having us.
Thanks so much.
Super fun. Stay live. As much more
to add.
Whatever banjo that thing was.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, we gotta keep on.
Just talking.
Thanks,
man.
Great.
Well,
we got the next
guest. Awesome.
Nice. I forgot to check out Ruby. Damn it.
That was awesome.
Really
so nice to meet you. Thank you.
Thanks so much. It was so much fun, man.
So much fun. You guys.
So anytime you're around, you pass us for days. Just hit us up. And, thank you. You know, seriously.
Thank you. That's so nice of you.
Yes.
I really appreciate it.
Anywhere, everywhere, you know. So.
Awesome.
You dug it, so.
I
saw you singing along.
Everything. And, all of it. So, I had a good time. Perfect.
Well, great to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well.
You guys were awesome.
Charlie, great to meet you.
Oh, Marty, nice to meet you too.
You guys can finish. No, you finish. I didn't want to.
Okay, just hit that. Sorry.